Hello everyone, welcome to A to Z Dentistry. In this video, we will discuss about X-ray films. There are two types of radiographic techniques in oral and maxillofacial radiography, that is intraoral radiography and extraoral radiography. In intraoral radiography, the image receptor is placed inside the patient's mouth and X-rays are directed from outside the patient's mouth. And in extraoral radiography, the image receptor is placed outside the patient's mouth and X-rays are also directed from outside the patient's mouth. In dental radiology, we commonly use intraoral radiographic techniques using small films which will reduce the patient exposure and we obtain an image with a superior quality. Now we will discuss about the films that is used in intraoral radiography. There are three types of intraoral radiographs. First one is IOPA or intraoral periapical radiograph. These are used to record the crowns, roots and surrounding bone of a very limited number of teeth. Next is bite wing radiograph or interproximal radiograph. These are used to record the coronal portions of the maxillary and the mandibular teeth in one image and they are useful for detecting interproximal caries and evaluating the height of the alveolar bone. Next is the occlusal radiograph. It is used to show larger areas of the maxilla or the mandible than may be seen on a periapical radiograph. And these films are used to obtain right angle views to the periapical views. And these are used to see lesions on the palate, impacted teeth, submandibular salivary stones and other pathologies. Now we will see what are the contents of the intraoral film packet. An intraoral film packet has an outer packet wrapper, a black paper film wrapper, thin lead foil sheet and the intraoral film. The outer plastic wrapping is made up of white paper or soft vinyl and is semi-stiff. And it is moisture proof and light proof. And this outer wrapper serves to protect the film from exposure to light and saliva. It has two sides. The front side and the back side. The front side is completely white in color whereas back side has two different shades. The front side is also called as tube side because while taking a radiograph, this side of the film should face the X-ray tube. And this can be identified with the help of a raised dot that is present on the corner of the film. And this raised dot is also called as embossed dot. And when inserted in the mouth for taking a radiograph, the edge carrying this embossed dot should be placed at the incisive or the occlusal margin of the tooth that is under consideration. And after the film has been exposed and processed, the dot is used to orient the patient's right and left side images properly. And when mounting radiographs, each film is oriented with the convex side of the dot towards the viewer. Next is the back side. It has a flap that is used to open the film packet to remove the film prior to processing. This is also called as label side because it has some labelings such as the manufacturer's name, the film speed, the number of films that is enclosed within the packet. As well as it has a labeling such as opposite side towards the tube, which means while taking a radiograph, the back side is away from the X-ray tube. So this labeling will also help us to identify the front and the back sides. Next is a sheet of black paper. You can see here that the X-ray film that is marked as number 4 is completely enclosed within the black paper which is marked as number 3. And the function of this black paper is to protect the film from any light leakage. Next is a sheet of lead foil. It is placed in the plastic wrapper on the back side of the film which is removed to the tooth under consideration and X-ray tube. Here you can see that this is the back side of the film with the labeling and this is the lead foil that is marked as number 2. This foil absorbs most of the X-rays which pass through the film and prevent them from reaching the tongue and other oral tissues. Thus, it helps to reduce the patient exposure. It also absorbs backscatter radiation and thus prevents fogging of the film. Otherwise, this fogging would cause a loss of important diagnostic detail. A secondary function of this lead foil is to give sufficient rigidity to the whole film packet. Suppose the film packet is reversed by taking a radiograph, that is, if backside is facing the X-ray tube when a radiograph is taken, the shadow of the foil will be seen on the resultant radiograph, and this appearance is called as tire track marks or herringbone appearance, which is the embossed pattern placed on the lead foil by the manufacturer. Next is the X-ray film. This is the main component of the film packet and it is marked as number 4. When we take a radiograph, the image is formed on this X-ray film. Now we will have a detailed description of this film. The composition of the film is base, adhesive, emulsion and supercoat. This is a cross-section of a film. This is the base. On either side of the base, an adhesive is applied that helps to attach the emulsion to the base. This is the emulsion. This is a double emulsion film, that is, emulsion is present on both sides of the film. Emulsion is the main component of the film. On top of the emulsion, a super coat is present which will protect the film from any mechanical damage. So first one is the base. It is a transparent supporting material upon which the emulsion is coated. The dental film base is composed of polyethylene terephthalate about 0.2 mm thick, and for optimal viewing of the diagnostic detail, the film base should have a bluish tint. And the base is uniformly translucent and cast no pattern on the resultant radiograph. The film is known as a safe film if the base is made up of acetate polyester, because this is not easily inflammable. Next is adhesive or subcoating. It is applied on both sides of the film base and it attaches the emulsion to the base. Next is the emulsion. This is the main component which is sensitive to X-rays and record the radiographic image. It is coated on both sides of the base containing silver bromide crystals that is suspended in gelatin. So silver halide crystals are photosensitive and composed primarily of silver bromide, that is 80-99%, and to a lesser extent of silver iodide crystals, that is about 1-10%. And the mean diameter of silver iodide grain is about 0.7 to 0.75 mm. The presence of silver iodide crystals add greatly to the sensitivity of the film emulsion. The photosensitivity of silver halide crystals is further increased by the incorporation of sulfur contamination during the manufacturing process. The silver halide crystals absorb radiation during X-ray exposure and convert them into invisible latent image. These silver halide crystals are suspended in a gelatin matrix. This gelatin matrix supports the silver halide crystals and it is applied on both sides of the supporting base. It is made from cattle bone and it helps to keep the silver grains evenly dispersed. And during processing, the gelatin absorbs processing solution and helps to allow the chemicals to react with the halide grains. Next is the supercoat. This is an additional layer of gelatin. It is a protective, transparent, non-abrasive layer that is present over the emulsion. It is applied to the surface to serve as a protective barrier and protects the film from damage by mechanical handling such as scratching, contamination and pressure from rollers during automatic processing. Next is classification of X-ray films. There are various classification systems for X-ray films. According to use, they can be classified into intraoral films and extraoral films. There are three types of intraoral films: periapical films, bite wing films and occlusal films. And based on size, these periapical films are of three types: size number 0, which is of size 22-35 mm, which is used in children; size 1, 24-40 mm for adult anterior region; size 2, 31-41 mm, used for adult posterior region. And bite wing radiograph also has four sizes: size 0 to size 3. Size 0 is 22-35 mm for child posterior. Size 1 is 24x40mm for adult anterior. Size 2 is 22x35mm for adult posterior. And size 3 is 27x54 for all posterior. Next is the occlusal radiograph, which comes in size 57x76mm. These are the various size representations for the X-ray film. This is a size 2 periapical radiograph. This is a size 3 bidwing radiograph. And this is the occlusal radiograph. Extraoral films are those that are placed outside the mouth during X-ray exposure. They are used to examine larger areas of the skull and the jaws. They are of different types, that is lateral oblique, which has a size of 5x7 inches, cephalometric films, which has 8x10 inches, skull radiography 10x12 inches, and panoramic film has 6x12 inches size. Next is, based on coating of emulsion, they can be classified into single coated films and double coated films. Single coated films has emulsion only on one side of the film. These produce better and sharper images, but the exposure to the patient is more. So it is mostly used in industrial radiography and duplicating films. Whereas double coated films have emulsion on both sides. Most dental films are double coated and these allow the less exposure to the patient. Next classification is based on the speed of the film. Speed refers to the amount of radiation that is required to produce an image of standard density. That means, higher the film speed, less exposure is required to produce a radiograph compared to slow speed films to form a similar image of same contrast and density. And the film speed depends on various factors such as size of the silver bromide crystals, the thickness of the emulsion, the presence of special radiosensitive dyes, etc. So based on speed, they can be classified into slow films and fast films. Slow films have a very small grain of silver bromide and emulsion is on one side only. Therefore, it gives better definition, but the exposure required is more and are thus not routinely used. An alphabetical classification is used to identify the film speed. So their speeds are denoted by A, B and C. Next is the fast films. They have a larger grain size and the emulsion is present on both sides of the base. Their speeds are D, that is ultra speed, E, ecta speed and F, ultra ecta speed. A hyper speed G film is also available. It is an 800 speed film that can halve the patient exposure without blurring, with the improved image quality. Then based on packing, it is classified into single film packet and double film packet. In single film packet, there is only a single film that is present in one packet, whereas in double film packet, two films are placed close to each other. When they are radiographed, the second film will act as a duplicating film. Then based on use of or non-use of screens, it can be classified into screen films and non-screen films. All intraoral films are non-screen films or direct exposure films. Because here, once the X-rays passes through the patient's body, these X-rays will expose the dental films. Whereas in screen films, these X-rays are converted into visible rays with the help of intensifying screens that is present on the cassette, and these visible lights will expose the dental film. So that is an indirect radiographic technique that is used with the help of intensifying screens and screen films. Screen films and intensifying screens are used for extraoral projections such as panoramic and cephalometric radiographs. So these screen films are sensitive to visible rays. So they contain an additional component that is sensitive to the light. Here the silver halide crystals are coated with sensitizing dyes to increase the absorption. It is important to use the appropriate screen film combination recommended by the screen and the film manufacturer, so that blue screen should be combined with the blue sensitive film and green screen should be combined with the green sensitive film. To increase the sharpness of the image, some manufacturers add an absorbing dye in the film emulsion. This dye reduces the light from one screen crossing through the film to reach the emulsion on the opposite side. EVG film from Carestream Dental is an example of this type of a film. Next is film protection and storage. To prevent film fog, the unexposed, unprocessed film must be kept in a cool and dry place. Film is adversely affected by heat, humidity, and radiation. The optimum temperature for film storage ranges from 50 to 70 degree Fahrenheit. And optimum relative humidity levels ranges from 30 to 50%. And the film must be stored in areas that are adequately shielded from the sources of radiation and should not be stored in areas where the patients are exposed to radiation. To prevent film fog, lead lined or radiation resistant film dispensers and storage boxes are ideal. All dental X-ray film has a limited shelf life. Each box or container of the film is clearly labeled with an expiration date. The first in, first out rule of thumb should be applied to film use. The oldest film in stock always used before any new film. To watch more videos on dental radiology, please like and subscribe our channel. Thank you.